Hi there, Mihail is here. You bought your first telescope. My congratulations! But you also need to know how to use your telescope. Therefore, if you are too lazy to read the instructions, then this video is for you. Now I will teach you how to use your telescope and what you should know during your first observations. I will show everything on the example of my Celestron Travelscope 70, but this video is suitable for all models of telescopes. Let's start! So, you mounted your first telescope, but you have no idea how to use it. Before learning how to use a telescope, we have to understand which type of telescope you got. There are several types of telescopes: refractors, reflectors, and compound or catadioptric telescopes. But how to understand which type of telescope do you have? Well, you can see it in the instructions or on the manufacturer's website, but who needs it? Instead, look inside your telescope's tube. If inside you see a lens, then you have a refractor. If inside you see this sink and a large mirror at the end of the tube, then you have a reflector. And if inside you see a lens and in the middle there is a circle, then you have a catadioptric telescope. All kinds of telescopes are great, but in the next video we will make detailed examination. Also, there are two main types of mounts: an azimuth mount and an equatorial mount. Also, some reflectors have Dobsonian mount, that is a variation of the azimuth mount. If you have equatorial mount, then to work properly it should be aligned with Polaris, the North Star, but this is not necessary at your first observations. The instruction on how to align the equatorial mount I left in the description. Now we should find out two of its main characteristics. The first one is the aperture. Aperture is the diameter of its light-gathering lens or mirror, often called the objective. The aperture's diameter, or just D, will be expressed either in millimeters or less commonly in inches. The larger the aperture, the more light the telescope can collect and the more objects you can see. In this picture you can clearly see it. The larger the telescope, the better. This guy is probably shocked by his telescope. The second characteristic is objective's focal length. For refractors and reflectors, the focal length is equal to the length of the tube. If you have a catadioptric telescope, then it is normal that the length of the tube is not equal to the focal length. Both of these characteristics are written on the tube of your telescope. If you didn't see such info on the tube, then you will have to look in the instructions or on the manufacturer's website. Now, before you start observing, you have to remove the telescope cover. Most telescopes have small cover inside the larger cover. It is needed in order to make a solar filter from a larger cover for observing the sun. Attention! It is forbidden to observe the sun through a telescope without a solar filter. Otherwise, you will become blind and will not be able to see the new era of space colonization. The next step. Most telescopes are equipped with such stuff. They are called eyepieces. Eyepieces are multi-lens components that allow you to achieve different magnifications with your telescope. You cannot start observing with just a telescope and no eyepieces. Also, some numbers are always written on the eyepieces. This is eyepiece's focal length. What is eyepiece's focal length purpose of? With eyepiece's focal length, you can calculate what magnification your telescope gives with this eyepiece. To do this, we need to divide the focal length of your telescope by the focal length of the eyepiece. For example, if a telescope has a focal length of 700 mm and you have a 10 mm eyepiece, then the magnification is 700 divided by 10, or 70 times. Such telescope will give a magnification of 70 times. You can change the magnification by switching eyepieces with different focal lengths. An important point: the maximum magnification that can be obtained on your telescope can be found by mentioned formula. For example, if your telescope has a 70 mm aperture, then we multiply by 2. And we get that the maximum magnification on this telescope is 140 times. If the magnification on this telescope is more than 140 times, then the image through the telescope will be of terrible quality. So how to use an eyepiece? We take the eyepiece, insert eyepiece into the telescope, observe through the eyepiece. Bingo! Okay, let's continue. Also, you may find another one stuff. This is Barlow lens. It is needed to increase the magnification of your telescope by a certain number of times. This number is written on the Barlow lens itself. How to use the Barlow lens? Take the Barlow lens, insert the eyepiece into the Barlow lens, insert this construction into the telescope. Bingo! Oh, I forgot about one more thing. Star diagonal. It is in refractor's kit, and its main purpose is more comfortable observation. Insert the star diagonal into the telescope and the result is obvious. Agree, with star diagonal is much more convenient to observe. The next thing that many people forget about is the focuser. Focuser is needed in order to focus the image. How to use your focuser? Very simple. For example, we look at a neighboring house through a telescope, but instead of a house, we see an incomprehensible blurry crap. Of course, we may believe that it is UFO that is trying to kidnap people, but instead we use a focuser and start spinning it. We spin the focuser until we see the house clearly. Now you know how to use your focuser, and let's continue. Now consider one more thing. Finderscope. Finderscope is such a small telescope which is needed to make it easier to find various objects. It can be compared with a rifle scope. So, how to use finderscope? First of all, you have to align your finderscope. We take finderscope and fasten it to the telescope. After that, we point the telescope at a neighboring house. The only thing you have to do is to set up the finderscope so the cross chairs are pointing to the same house as the telescope. To do this, we use these screws, which we begin to twist until the image of the neighboring house is exactly in the center. Great, finderscope is aligned. Now, when we need to see some object in the sky, we just point finderscope to it. Well, now you know how to use your telescope. But before you start your first observations, you need to practice a little during the day. Then, in the night, it will be easier for you to observe. To do this, we repeat all the actions that we did before, namely, take your telescope, take your eyepieces, and if you have Barlow lens, remove the telescope cover, align your finderscope, practice to point your telescope at various houses and objects. Also, do not forget to use a focuser. And it is also best to observe on the balcony or on the street, then the image through the telescope will be clearer. It is better not to observe through the window, because then the picture will be very blurry. If there are no alternatives, then observe through an open window. Well, that's all you need to know for your first observations. And then, in the night, you can take your telescope and finally enjoy the beautiful views of space. By the way, what is the weather forecast for this night? Mainly cloudy.